Hi, I'm Andrew Strom, and welcome to a tutorial on how to use a backsaw for cutting joinery. For this demonstration, I'm going to make a cross cut in this piece. It could serve as the shoulder of a tenon or the sidewall of a rabbit or dado. The technique is going to be the same too for cutting a dovetail joint, or even cross-cutting using a bench hook. So we're going to start with how I'll stand. My feet are about a shoulder's width apart, and I'm standing at a slight angle to the bench. Pick up the saw. I'm going to hold it with a three-fingered triangulated grip. And what this does is it gives me some lateral stability. When I start, I'm going to use my thumb as a positive stop to help ensure that I don't overcut when starting. And I'm going to start at the back and drop the saw into this stop cut that I've made. And starting at the back and having the saw angled slightly, that relaxes the rake of the teeth, or has the effect of relaxing the rake of the teeth, and makes the saw a little easier to start. But the keys are controlling the saw in the horizontal and vertical planes. So I want to cut square to the edge of the board, which means that I need to be aware of the position of my elbow relative to my body. So if, as you're sawing, you're struggling with cutting squarely to the edge of the work, it's generally an issue with the position of your elbow. Try moving your elbow in the appropriate direction. And if that isn't a comfortable position for you anymore, reposition your feet. Take a small half step left or right, depending, and it'll be more comfortable for you. Controlling the saw in the vertical plane is influenced by the position of my wrist. So if I tilt my wrist one way or the other, again, very small movement in my hand position translates to a fairly large movement at the tooth line. This is essentially a lever, so everything is magnified. That minute movement makes a big difference right at the tooth line. So if you're struggling with cutting vertically, pay attention to the position of your wrist and its rotation. And then the third point to mention is from my shoulder through my elbow and my wrist right the way out to the end of the spine. Think of a piston going back and forth as smoothly and evenly as possible. And those are the secrets to making an accurate saw cut. So, I'm going to start away from me, drop it into the kerf, and go back and forth as smoothly and evenly as I can. Oops. Check again, coming up on the line. There we go. So if I put a square on it, and see that I'm cutting square to the edge. Just unclamp it, and we'll check its squareness in the other plane. Could have cut a little more deeply, but there you go. You can see that I've cut straight up and down. So there you have it. A quick overview and tutorial on how to cut joinery, the essential body mechanics when working with a backsaw. And I would encourage you to practice. I often, before I start a working session, I'll often make a series of practice cuts just to warm up, and I find that it's a cliche to say it, but it comes back to me. It's like riding a bicycle. You get that sense of what's vertical and what's square, and you develop the muscle memory of how to make an accurate cut. So thanks very much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.